William Hill sponsors Seconds Out.
I'm interested to know your thoughts. The fight tomorrow, Joseph has fought both of these guys, beat Andy Ruiz in a decision, lost to Joshua on a decision. What do you think about this fight? I mean, I'm interested to get your opinion. You probably know as well as anybody how this fight might go on Saturday.
Well, obviously, you know, Joe fighting both guys, we've studied both guys in detail. And, you know, let's talk a wee bit about Andy Ruiz. Inactivity has probably been his biggest problem. If you go back to 2016, he fought four times in 2016, and we were his fourth fight that year. So it'd be fair to say he was in pretty good shape when he fought Joe for the title in New Zealand. And Andy's a very, very fast starter. He started fast in the fight against Joe and won the first three rounds on all judges' cards. The next year he sat the whole year out after making some money and fighting Joe. Then he changed promoters. He had two fights in 18. And then, as we all know, he fought Dimitrenko recently. And the fact that that fight was only 6 weeks ago, I believe, will help Andy. He's had weight issues. The last fight with Dimitrenko, he was 262. This fight, I think today, he'll come in the low 50s. I think a lot of people are kidding themselves with the odds on this fight for Andy Ruiz. You know, I read somewhere 33-1, 25-1. Andy Ruiz is a very, very good fighter, and he has to be in the top 10 or 12 heavyweights in the world at the moment. No doubt about it. He's a skilled fighter. He's a fighter who was a very good amateur. He's had a tremendously successful career as a professional. And let's remember, he's not 6'2", he's 6 foot. But he's always fought taller guys. It's people say, oh, well, he's 6 inches shorter than Joshua, and Joshua's got 8 inches reach on him. Andy's come up against that every single time just about throughout his career. It's a guy that has very good hand speed for a heavyweight. He's got good head movement for the first three or four rounds, and we know he works very, very well to the body. If anything, a criticism, I believe, is the fact that, you know, he uses that jab to the body to close the distance on the taller guy to try and get inside. And the fact that he sometimes reaches with that jab, which I see being a problem if he overreaches with Joshua. Now, talking about Joshua, I believe it's a guy that has definitely improved over the last couple of years. When people look at and they talk about the fight against Dillian White, totally different guy, a fighter who has learnt his trade, a fighter who is developing every time he gets into the ring, a fighter who probably controls the distance better than any other heavyweight in the world today. I know you probably don't want to hear from me anymore.
This is an amazing analysis. I was hoping you'd just say AJ was going to win. Go on, kick it.
No, look, I think it's a fight that Andy Ruiz is going to have to eat a bunch of leather to close the distance with Joshua. And I'm sure that Andy, in his mind, is prepared to eat leather. You know, he's done it before. We saw the fight, his most recent fight, Dimitrenko. Dimitrenko hit him with flush right hands. Now, if Joshua hits him with that same right hand, how many can he take? We know that he has heart. We know that he has no fear. We know that he's a very, very good boxer. And simply, Joshua's going to have to break him down, hurt him, and knock him out to beat him.
Thank you. Thank you. Fascinating. Fascinating.
William Hill sponsors Seconds Out.